anything, everything I could imagine. Now, in an interview on a radio station in Tampa Bay, you had said that maybe Doug was a lot smarter than a lot of people thought and did a phony walkthrough during the Super Bowl, right before the Super Bowl. So did that happen? Did he go out there knowing that some of those cheaters in New England might have been videotaping or watching what you guys were doing?
You know, I didn't know the exact game plan of that walkthrough just because I'm a long snapper, I'm not an offense, I'm not a defense, but I thought I heard someone say, hey, you know, there's a lot of these plays are fake. We don't want anyone walking around up on top of the stadium looking down at us and writing a few things down or anything like that. So it was something that we need to do. I mean, we heard a lot of things from the past, so we just do it. We go out there and run a fake walkthrough.
That's next level thinking by Doug Peterson, isn't it? Do people believe the Patriots would have cheated like that? Yeah, me too. All right, Rick, so the tattoo, you have Lombardi himself or the trophy on there. Let's take a look at that. Can you see that, everybody? Look at that. Wow. All right, so did this, after you won, you said to yourself, all right, I'm going to get this done. Did you go into the Super Bowl saying that if you won, you were going to get it done? How did that all transpire?
There's a whole story to that. I don't get a tattoo just to get a tattoo. Obviously, this Super Bowl and everything, it's my dream ever since I was a kid. The whole story behind it was, this party is actually buried in my hometown, Middletown, New Jersey. And so I went to go visit this grave 2 years ago. I was with the Packers, obviously, he was a Packers head coach. I just went and paid my respects to him, and I got cut by the Packers, and I got cut by the Redskins, and I joined the Eagles 2 weeks later, and ever since I joined the Eagles, it was just a path that led to greatness, and so that whole story, and all that blood, sweat, and tears put into that, to this trophy, and what this team did this year, and accomplishing all the goals that we did, it was just incredible, and I knew that I needed to get the tattoo on me, because it means the entire world to me, and nothing is exciting me more than the Super Bowl.
Why the hell not, right? Anybody else out there get an Eagle tattoo after they won the Super Bowl? Raise your hands. A man right there did. I have my hand raised right here. Unbelievable. Alright, so does Nick Foles get traded?
No, we need him. We want him.
Everybody want Nick Foles coming back? Very good. So now that you're a Super Bowl champion, when do you get the ring? When does all that happen? Right before the season?
June, actually. So I'm hoping that in June there's a big celebration around the whole ring ceremony. But someone said June, and I still believe it's in June. So I'm waiting for that June to come up real quick, because I want that thing right on my ring finger.
I agree. Swoop, do you get a ring? Do you? Let me see. I don't know where it's going to go. All right, last thing. Here, the parade. How many people were here at the parade? Everybody? Pretty much everybody. I can imagine you were at the parade if you're here tonight trying to get the season tickets. What was that like for you? I know for me, as someone who's lived here my entire life, it was almost, I still can't believe that it happened. What was it like being on the float, turning the corner on the City Hall and seeing that many people?
Life just didn't seem real at that point. You know, seeing all you guys come out there and supporting the team that won the Super Bowl, but it wasn't about us, it was about you guys. You guys seriously devoted 50 plus years of your life waiting for this championship to come. And honestly, this one's for you guys. Yeah, this is the best city in the entire world.
Ladies and gentlemen, Super Bowl champion, Rick.